grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
Good evening, everyone. Today we have much to celebrate. The church celebrates the feast of the Ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ, and at this particular Mass, we're also celebrating the 50th anniversary of the class of 73's graduation, Catholic High School. And there, in the bulk over there, is one of our teachers, Sister Marie, is with us too, and that's very special to me, and I know to all of you there, so God bless you, and thank you for being with us, as you were 50 years ago. So, to begin this Mass with all of these things to be thankful for, let us call to mind our sins, and be grateful for a Savior who is compassionate, merciful, and just. Let us call to mind these sins. We ask the Lord for his pardon and his peace. I confess to Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters,
from the Acts of the Apostles. In the first first book, Theophilus, I dealt with all that Jesus did and taught until the day he was taken up. After giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen, he presented himself alive to them by many proofs after he had suffered, appearing to them during 40 days, speaking about the kingdom of God. While meeting with them, he enjoined them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, about which you have heard me speak. For John baptized with water, and in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. When they had gathered together, they asked him, Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel? He answered them, It is not for you to know the times or the seasons that the Father has established by his own authority. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, through Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were looking on, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him from their sight. While they were looking intently at the sky as he was going, suddenly two men dressed in white garments stood beside them. They said, Men of Galilee, why are you standing there looking at the sky? This Jesus who has been taken up from you into heaven will return in the same way as you have seen him going into heaven. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, may the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation, resulting in knowledge of him. May the eyes of your hearts be enlightened, that you may know what is the hope that belongs to his call. What are the riches of glory in his inheritance among the holy ones? And what is the surpassing greatness of his power for us who believe? In accord with the exercise of his great might, which he worked in Christ, raising him from the dead, and seating him at his right hand in the heavens, far above every principality, authority, power, and dominion, and every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the one to come. And he put all things beneath his feet, and gave him as head over all things to the church, which is his body, the fullness of the one who fills all things in every way. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
This evening, we celebrate an event that happened over 2,000 years ago. It's documented by witnesses, described with just a few words that help our imaginations visualize what the original witnesses saw as Jesus was lifted up and a cloud took him from their sight. Now, maybe those of us who remember going to the airport before there were so many restrictions where we couldn't get on the airfield and saying goodbye to our loved ones, they get in an airplane and we see them ascend and we wave. Sometimes we can see them wave back until the cloud takes them from our sight. This is probably the closest experience we could have to this type of thing, saying goodbye to somebody who's ascending. But on this day for the apostles, this was a bittersweet, wondrous moment. Sometimes even for us when we say so long to our friends when we're visiting. But for them it was a bittersweet, wondrous moment. They had gathered there with Jesus. He told them to gather one more time, or at least come to this mountain. I want to see you one more time. He didn't tell them he's going to ascend before them. That's why I call Jesus my favorite nickname, with all due respects. He was a divine show-off. So this would be the second time for the apostles within approximately 44, 45 days that Jesus would be taken away from them. The first time was horrific and traumatic at his crucifixion, death, and then there was his burial. But after 3 days, he rose from the dead and presented himself alive to them for about 40 days, speaking to them of the kingdom of God and eventually commissioning them to go forward and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that he had commanded them. This day of our Lord's Ascension was the apostles' graduation day. They finished their basic instruction from the one himself, Jesus Christ. And they would get their master's degree on evangelization from the Holy Spirit, who was the follow-up teacher that Jesus promised to send them, who they received on Pentecost, about 10 days after Jesus ascended to heaven. As I mentioned earlier, this event, this day, this Mass, also we celebrate another event. This particular event happened 50 years ago. It's documented by witnesses. They're all sitting here in this section, right? Some of them present at this Mass, Catholic High School class of 73. Welcome to St. John the Evangelist Catholic Church for this Mass. Some of you, I believe, may have even gone to this school before you went to Catholic High. So 50 years ago, you graduated from Catholic High School with a similar commission. A similar commission that the apostles received from Jesus on their graduation day. But you and I, as I graduated in 72, so I'm a lot older than you. He told them, he tells us, go make disciples of all nations. Share the gift of your faith. Now, many of the teachers we had at Catholic High School during the 70s were living out this apostolic commission in their lives as priests, nuns, and lay teachers. So, again, I just acknowledge Sister Marie here at this Mass. She taught English and martial arts. Not the second. Let's applaud them. Thank you for this. So our Sister Marie and Sister Consuela, Sister Jean, Father Pine, Mr. Alfred, sorry, I can go down the list, what they were doing there, they were passing on the Catholic faith to us during the turbulent time of political and social unrest during 1973, in the early 70s, was happening then, you may recall. The Vietnam War was winding down. The United States Supreme Court overturned state bans on abortion with Roe versus Wade. The Watergate scandal was going to just expand like a mushroom and take most of the headlines for the rest of that decade. Richard Nixon was president then. Race relationships were improving, but further progress needed to be made. The company ITT was bombed in New York City by a local terrorist group called Weather Underground, protesting its involvement in the 1973 Chilean coup. Elton John released Goodbye Yellow Brick Road, a double album. Other hits from that time, Midnight Train to Georgia, by whom? Very good. Diamond Girl, by whom? Angie, by whom?
Rolling Stones.
All right. It's very smart class. But you know, I wonder, what was Sister Consuela, Sister Jean, Mr. Wayne Merritt, Father Pine, R.C. Lipscomb, Father William Joseph, think of the turbulent times we live in today. I'm looking forward to getting Sister Marie off to a car and discussing this a little bit later at the reception. So, and I ask the students here, do you think we were instructed well at Catholic High during the 70s to deal with the persecutions we face today, 50 years afterwards, as Catholic Christians? The rise of socialism, especially being taught in the colleges, the woke movement, threats of global reset that seeks to demolish freedom of conscience, speech, religion, and the currency we use, a pandemic of sexual immorality, even more so than what we grew up with, after the consequences of the Woodstock gathering. Definite increase of demonic activity, demonic organizations, and gender ideologies that are targeting our children even as young as kindergarten, and grandchildren through indoctrination, posing as education and entertainment. And we also observe strict and sometimes inhumane treatment of immigrants. This evening, on the feast of the Vigil of Ascension, may we realize and appreciate what we celebrate. We're in the Easter season. We celebrate joy. We celebrate so many things. But I know some of you sitting here, and myself, in this Easter season, I've had to officiate a good number of funerals. How do we bring our faith in the resurrection to the new journey of grief that some of us entered into this past year? We are celebrating with the Ascension hope in the face of bad news, a faith that challenges us to a knowledge beyond the vision of our sight, and love that is meant to be unconditional and immortal. Let us be confident and experience Jesus' fulfillment of the promise he made to his apostles on the day of his Ascension. He said, as he was departing from them, "Behold, behold, I am with you always until the end of the ages." Are you feeling his presence? Have you been faithful to go deeper into the ultimate gift he gives of himself in the Holy Eucharist? His body, blood, soul, and divinity in the Holy Eucharist is the predominant way that he is keeping this promise. "Behold, I am with you always until the end of time." I now quote from Pope St. Leo the Great to remind us of the significance of Jesus' ascension into heaven. He was a pope many, many, many years ago, over 100, I think, I forget his pontificate, but he texted me today and he said, "Quote me this Mass." And he wrote, "With all due solemnity, we are commemorating that day on which our poor human nature was carried up in Christ above all the hosts of heaven, above all the ranks of angels, beyond the highest heavenly powers, to the very throne of God the Father." That sounds all very nice, but what does that look like? I mean, I notice on our bulletin, you may see it. Here's what it says: "God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets to the Lord." And some artists, under inspiration, you see Jesus sitting here. And then next to him is a real old man with a white beard. I guess that's God the Father. Or it's Leon Russell before he died. I don't know. No, that's the way in the art God the Father is depicted, portrayed as an older, being a father, being older, Jesus being younger, and then in the form of a child of the Holy Spirit. Actually, it's a beautiful, beautiful picture. But what are we imagining? How can we see that? Though we may be challenged in visualizing how Jesus ascended into the heavens, even with the description of his disciples, who said, "He was lifted up, and a cloud took him from our sight." It is what happened afterwards, where the light of our believing souls, as Pope Leo the Great says, the light of our believing souls puts unhesitating faith in what is not seen with the bodily eye, and we fix our desires on those beyond our sight. That's what the artist of this picture is trying to do. What does it look like? Well, we don't really need to know what it looks like, but we do need to know the Lord who ascended into heaven, and the rest will follow. Our fidelity to Jesus Christ could never be born in our hearts, nor can anyone be justified by faith if our salvation lay in only the things that are visible. This is from Pope Brady the Great. So I feel sorry for the scientists of today that have made science their God and placed God someplace else, if at all anywhere. We walk by faith and not by sight. In Jesus, his life, death, and resurrection, we know the good news of the gospel is that life is eternal, love is immortal, and death is only a horizon. So dear parishioners, friends, and Catholic high school class of 73, Let us celebrate Jesus among us in the present moment and allow him to transform us as witnesses of hope, as he did to his apostles, who both glorified him on that hill, but as we heard, they also needed reassurance from whatever doubts they held in their hearts. They had some doubts, it's mentioned, but what were these doubts? I believe whatever doubts they had, mainly focused on doubting, well, so what do we do now? I don't know if I can do this. Well, they had these doubts, I assure you, that these doubts vanished once they received the Holy Spirit. For the Holy Spirit empowered them to do what they thought they could never possibly do. I know this is true myself as a student at Catholic High in 1972. If you told me I was going to be a Catholic priest preaching to the class of 73 and pastor of this parish, I would have said, I have my doubts about it. In fact, I know other people that did it too. One of my teachers, none whose name we withheld. I love her very much, but we haven't talked in a long time. Not because of what she said. And she heard that I was going to become a priest, and she told her friend who got back to me, "You've got to be kidding." A very valid response. It's great. It's wonderful. Okay? So, we have life to live, no matter how long or how short. Who is God calling us to be now? We are the evangelizers. It's a challenging world, but let's not be afraid of it. Let's move forward with confidence. And when they say, you can't do this, you can't do that, do it. We're here to please God first, and these naysayers, whatever. Let's hold on with grace to be able to become the saints that the Lord is calling us to be in this world today. The story of evangelization continues in our life. We are completing and still writing the Acts of the Apostles. So class of 73, and everybody else here, let's continue writing this story. It's a victorious one. Jesus wins. Stand for the pledge of faith. I believe in one God. Our risen Savior ascended into heaven, angels reminded his disciples that he would come back again. Until he comes, we continue his work by praying for all peoples and their needs.
That the church on earth will ever keep to his evangelical mission of making disciples of all nations, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the leaders of the world may realize they must give an account of the work of Jesus Christ when he returns as our judge. Let us pray to the Lord.
our seminarians, for women studying for religious life, for those who train and serve in our armed forces, and for our first responders, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our intentions offered in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our Father in heaven, your Son is now seated at your right hand, enthroned in eternal glory. We make our petitions through him, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, you will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God.
Wash me, O Lord, from my iniquity. Cleanse me from my sin. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice of yours will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Holy Spirit coming near, we pray, O Lord, prepare our minds for the divine sacrament, since the Spirit himself is the remission of all sins, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the Lord Jesus, King of glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended to the highest heavens as the angels gazed in wonder. Mediator between God and man, judge of the world and Lord of hosts, he ascended not to distance himself from our lowly state, but that we, his members, might be confident of following where he, our head and founder, has gone before. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers of the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, for the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather your people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, your sacrifice will be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We believe the bread and drink this cup. We proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant, Francis, our Pope, and William, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you, and your compassionate and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, to whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Give us this day our daily bread.
Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you.
Always your spirit.
Let's offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. I'd like to invite family and friends who may be here tonight for this Mass and do not receive the Eucharist to come forward for a blessing if you so desire and place your hands this way so I know to give you the blessing. Communion is distributed on this aisle and then on this one.
Thank you.
May the gifts we have received from your altar, Lord, kindle in our hearts a longing for the heavenly homeland and cause us to press forward, following in the Savior's footsteps, to the place where, for our sake, he entered before us, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for some of the announcements for the parish here, and just to let you know, you may have wondered, well, don't they take up a collection? Well, we do, but we do it in a different way until maybe in a few weeks when we won't be passing the basket. But we have a place for people to put their offerings on the way out in the basket. So if you so desire to do it, that's your opportunity. But right now, I'd like to bring up our Director of Religious Education, Alejandro Duda. We have a big event happening in this summer. It's a vacation Bible school, and there's going to be a 1.5-minute video that is going to be shown as Alejandro is speaking. While they're trying to get that ready, I'll just come up with, let's see what other announcements that I have here. Okay. Okay, actually, I think the main announcement. Okay, we have this this Vacation Bible School has a space theme to it, so that's the count of a rocket. And take off the rocket might take off before we actually figure out how to show the rocket taking off. this happened before, so bear with us for now as we get this together.
Go in peace.